closer, young traveler.
Oh, no! Stop him! He won't...
No turning back!
No turning back!
Sneaky kids, sneaking up on me.
There was no doubt I had wanderlust, a need to go forwards, never retracing my steps, always curious about what lay ahead. I had traveled far from home in search of I knew not what. Always in the company of good and honest people who cared and provided for me. But in Alexandria, we had to go our separate ways. They made sure I had sufficient food and money, but I felt very alone. And then I heard it. Music that drew me, pulled me towards its source. It was Burhan al-Din Alami, the most venerable Sufi in Alexandria, and he foretold my destiny.
Come closer, young traveler. Yes, you, don't be afraid. Let me see the boy with a passion for travel so great he will wander as far as India and China, taking my greetings and goodwill to the three great Sufis he will find there, having many great adventures on the way.
Sir, I had never thought to travel so far. But now my wanderings will never cease until I have met these three and given them your greetings, but
how will you manage alone? By using your intuition. The very same intuition that drew you here. And you will find fellow travelers whom you can trust.
The Great Harbor, young sir. Could you point the way? I've to meet the Cassandra without any delay.
Of course it's a... That way, I think. Yes, it's that way. Definitely.
Oh, no! Stop him! He robbed me!
Stop him!
Well,
My intuition tells me he was up to no good. Oh, doesn't anybody look where they're going around here?
I've been robbed by a kindly old man who asked the way to the port, and he went this way.
Kindly? Old? Not at all spindly snake-like thing of indeterminate age.
What are you talking about? I've got to catch him or I'm done for. In fact, I'm probably done for anyway.
Come on, two's better than one. Let's go. You go this way. I'll go that. Stop him! Quickly!
We'll never find him in all of this. I knew I was done for.
Don't be so gloomy. We just need a few more clues. Did he say anything else?
He said something about Cassandra. I'm sure that's right. Cassandra.
Cassandra. Cassandra.
Yes, yes. You want passage?
You can't be Cassandra. That's a girl's name.
Come with me. You meet Cassandra. What's your name?
My name's Ibn Battuta, and...
I am Farhan. Who's asking?
I am.
And who are you? And where's this Cassandra?
I am Zing, and this is Maoki, and I am very, very proud to introduce to you Cassandra.
Where?
There.
But there's no one there.
But there's something.
Yes, the side of the boat. I see. The boat is called Cassandra.
Ah, my boat, on which I honored passenger. Out. Okay, we honored passenger. We sail again tomorrow.
I don't get it. Why would a sneaky thief first of all take my money and then tell me which boat he was getting?
I know. It doesn't make sense.
Sneak thief. Always hang round. Steal from passenger. Never caught. Steal from captain. Never look same. Always same man. Maoki know. He sense. He have animal instinct. He make dreadful lucky to him sneak thief round. Intuition.
Huh. Doesn't he always?
What?
Make a dreadful racket.
Intuition. Strange that word should come up again. Do you know what he's saying?
I do.
You understand, monkey.
He says the sneak thief is here. He's trying to leave. It's very hot for him at the moment. He has robbed too many people. He feels he must move to another city for a while. He may well try to get passage on the Cassandra. But he won't want to pay. He'll use his hypnotic tricks. But Maoki will find him.
If he's so good at disguise, how do we know that you're not him and just trying to trick us? Stop it! What's his problem?
Maoki says Sneak Thief has a mark on his arm. Whatever his disguise, he can never remove it. It's like a curse, a permanent identity mark. Anyway, he needs to look you straight in the eye for you to see someone else. By the way, my name is Sophia. I met Zing and Malky on the voyage here.
I'm sorry. I've been robbed and left without anything to buy food with.
Then let's make a plan to foil Sneak Thief and get that purse back.
Don't be silly.
That work?
Why me?
Together.
Set. No turning back.
No turning back.
Bye.
Bye.
Really tired.
Bye.
Sleep now.
Off shopping.
Sleep well.
See you tomorrow.
This is never going to work.
Shh.
You're tracked, Sneak Thief. Just give us back what's ours. You coward! She's just a wild
little girl.
My purse!
Where's Zing? He was supposed to protect the boat.
Never mind. Let him go. He won't mess with us again.
Sneaky kids, sneaking up on me. Well, I'm sneakier, as they'll soon see.
And so we unfurled Zing, returned all the jewels and gold to their rightful owners, all of who, unbidden, gave us a little something for our trouble and honesty. Farhan and I decided to join the others and travel east. I had found those travel companions I could trust. Farhan, our voice of caution. Sophia, so calm and so able to look after herself. Zing, such fun. Malky, how would we have coped without Malky? And me, Ibn Battuta, I was ready for those great adventures the Sufi had foretold. No turning back. And so, what did you learn from this adventure?
That crime doesn't pay.
True, young sir, but nearly as important, honesty does.
No turning back from this wonderful world that we see. No turning back. On the wind like a bird flying free, riding away, traveling to an unknown place, sailing away. You see new lands and a whole new world. Sail your seas for the sun's last ray.